Yeah, I love it. Done quite a few MCMs now, and they're just getting bigger and better. And yeah, everyone's been very nice.
And what's the appeal for you coming to events like this? What do you get out of the experience?
Bit of money. Yeah, it's just good fun. I'm a big fan of it too. Before I became an actor and started working on these big franchises, I was a fan. You know, I've been a massive Star Wars fan since I can remember. So to be a part of it and speak to people about it, explain what I do, which is a little bit different than probably most of the guests that are here, is great. Well, I'm a creature performer. Credited on the Star Wars films as a creature and droid puppeteer, but basically I'm an actor that they'll put in a suit, either with an animatronic head or prosthetic makeup, or sometimes motion capture on some movies. For example, working on the Marvel movies, I was part of the team that brought Skinny Steve to life, so they'd use me with different techniques of visual effects to create that character. So it's kind of like digital makeup in a way. So yeah, probably most known for the Marvel Skinny Steve and the Star Wars Force Awakens and Last Jedi creatures. Everyone's different, every creature's different anyway, because it depends. I made the mistake, first of all, coming from an actor's point of view, of preparing beforehand. I'm gonna walk like this, I'm gonna behave like this. You get in the suit and then you can't do what you plan to do. You can't move, you know. It's like, oh, I was going to jump around it. You're stuck like this. So what you have to do then is wait until you've had the first test fitting, then decide what you're going to do. And my very first job was with Stan Winston's studio. And there was a guy there, Shane Mohan, who now looks after it after Stan died. And he said something to me very valuable to me. He said, Whatever's happening to you while you're wearing whatever costume, he said, use it for the character. So if you can't walk properly, then, you know, use that as part of the character's motivation. So it depends what I'm wearing. If it's prosthetics, it's a little bit easier because you can emote through the silicone. If it's creature suits and creature heads, it's a little bit more difficult. You've got to be more physical.
Bob Jones is another creature actor.
Oh yeah, legend. Yeah. Hundred percent. Yeah, when I first started getting into it, I didn't decide to be a creature actor, but I was obsessed with him since I was little. My action figures were Greedo and Hammerhead and, you know, Nine Numb and all these guys. And I knew about Doug ever since he did Batman Returns, you know, and from then on. And then obviously the stuff he did with Del Toro, and he became a little bit of a mentor to me. And I've been communicating with Doug ever since I started this career, maybe 12 years ago. And he's always had such great kind words to say and encouragement, and he's the best. If ever I need to ask him something, he's there replying straight away. So Captain America was kind of, was that like the second one after Iron Man, I think, was it? It was one of the early ones. So, I mean, I knew what Marvel was. I grew up Fantastic Four and Spider-Man. I loved all that. You know, obviously being in the UK, we didn't really know Captain America as much, but I knew who he was as a character. Yeah, so when they said you're working on any Skinny Steve, I had to look at the character, I had to look at the comic, and I read the issues with some Skinny Steve stuff and getting an idea. I went, oh, okay, I get it. He's about my height and he's skinny, and yeah, he's a bit of a nerd. All right, I like it. But it was fun. I mean, everyone was cool and it was a great atmosphere. But I spent most of it with Lola Effects, and it was in their studio developing it in pre-production. So it was mainly me and Lola, and Joe Johnson would come in and check the stuff. And obviously when I got auditioned for it, I can't remember if Chris was there, but Joe Johnson was definitely there. And what they did is they lined up a load of Skinny Steves in a line, and it was as simple as that. And they had varying heights, and I think I was about in the middle. And Joe and the assistants just looked at the line and just came over to me and just said, what's your name? I said, boy, can you act? So I was like, yeah. He went, okay, you got the job. That's it. But I didn't know what the job was, you know. Next thing, they had my top off and they're taking pictures. And I'm like, oh, okay, it's one of those jobs. Oh, right. But yeah, they're all very nice and people. But I worked a lot with visual effects. And then on set, Chris was there. And there was another guy called Leander. Now, Leander did the majority of the body doubling after the pre-production and after the recruitment scene. That's all Leander. So I was there from the start, and I was a very small part of a big effect, so I can't claim to be the character. It's Chris's character, and I helped, and Leander helped, and that was it, really. But yeah, it was good fun. because not only was it people, a lot of people think it's just head replacement. It's not, it's pretty much skin replacement as well. I remember looking at it and people saying, oh, so it's your body with his head. No. I think that my contribution when they used me there was a reference for the movement, you know, and also for the other actors and obviously for the height and technically for the camera. It was very technical in that way. So it wasn't just simple. It was like taking his head and just sticking it on. But how they actually did it from then on, Lola showed me the tests and then, but the rest of it, I have no idea what they did till I saw it.
On set, when you did some of that skinny sleep, did it put on any practical effects just to, so it can emerge?
They had, I had orange dots on my face.
Oh, for the tracking?
Yeah, for the tracking, and on my chest. Leander, when he did his passes, they gave him prosthetics. So he had, I think they gave him like a, because we were both together on that scene. And I think they gave him nose, maybe brow. I don't know, but he definitely had a prosthetics on there so that he looked more like Chris. So basically, Chris would do a pass. It was the scene where you see with the newspaper the first time, you know, comes down and gets up. So I'd get up, then I'd walk over to the podium, do the lines. The actor was there. Can't remember the guy. British actor, but he was doing American. He'd deliver the line, and then Chris would do it. Then Leander would do it, and then, I don't know, then they, whatever they did. Like, so with the Stan Winston was my first job. I started out as a Harry Potter double on Order of the Phoenix. So I was Daniel's flying double on that movie. And from there, that's how I got the Skinny Steve, because I'd worked with some of the people and they were looking for a good performer, physical, who could just get on set and just do it. And then from there, someone that's recommended is Stan Winston, and I've worked on this horror movie called The Deaths of Ian. And from there, every job I ever got afterwards was like alien, monster, you know, anything like that. But I loved it. It was great. And I've kind of got a niche in it now after all these years, to the point where when Star Wars came along, they just offered me the job. There was no audition. It was just like, we're putting a team together. And I'd worked with some of the people in the creature department before, and they said, we're putting a team together. I want you to be a part of it. Do you want to come and work on Star Wars? I was like, Yeah.
I mean, I think everyone would love to be Harry Potter, especially on a broom playing Quidditch. Can you talk about what the reality of
that? Well, you say that, but I was 31 when I did it. I was born in 74. So so he was 17. I was 31. And I didn't know what Harry Potter was. I mean, I knew what it was. They'd done maybe two or three movies at that point. But you go down to the pub with your friends or you hang out. Yeah, they don't think it's cool. They think it's the funniest thing ever. You know, Star Wars, they think it's cool. You know, then I kind of redeem myself. But at the time, it's like, he's a boy wizard. Because I had to have the haircut as well, you know. For about 3 months, I had like the parting, and they gave me the glasses and the scar and all this. But it was cool, man. It was good working on it. But I did enjoy it. I learned a lot from it, especially how to behave on set, you know, what to do and marks and, you know, just all the technical side that you don't really know until you get on a movie. It doesn't matter how much acting experience you've got. You never know how to really behave on a film set or how to do film acting. It's completely different. But yeah, I learned a lot from it. It was good. Made a lot of friends.
Is there a franchise that you'd really like to work on?
Yeah, let's do some Doctor Who would be nice. Game of Thrones, you know, all of those other big ones would be very cool. A lot of the guys that do the makeup effects for it, I've got to know on other productions, they've said, oh, you'll be great in this, you'll be great. I'll be like, yeah, get me a job. But it's not as simple as just knowing people. It's got to be the right character. And, you know, I'm not the tallest dude, so it has to be a certain type of character, you know. But I'd love to do, yeah, anything. Work's work for me, I love it. Yeah, it'd be great.